Okay, so we reached the end of the tunnel, and this is a flooded room. I'd say that's a good 3 or 4 feet, depending on the spot. But it's up to the brim of this, so who knows how much longer this will ever be here. There's a door over there. Don't know. Watch your heads. These guys are changing batteries before going for a swim. Yeah, I heard something. This floor was also had linoleum. Let's see the squares. Wow, it's amazing how flooded this is. Oh my God. Awesome. At some point somebody had a bed down here.
Look at this. He's probably had a catwalk that went up. But look at the top. That's one of the blast doors. Or, yeah. I really don't know.
So obviously it's not deep enough. Unless I'm on a bunch of sediment and this is a false floor. It could be. Here's a big door. See, this also had a big blast door here. There you can see the hitch pins. You can see the rubber isolated mounts right there.
I would say this was one of the silos.
I don't know if this is a false floor, because obviously a silo would have been deeper. These missiles were long.
Okay, this is one of them.
I don't know what this is.
It's a cap, of course.
Well, that would be the blast door.
Yep. Awesome. But we had a Titan 1 missile.
Because look at the door that it closed off here. Here's another pretty thick. And then it was separate from here because it had this walkway. And notice the floor had hinges right here for this walkway.
That's the radioactive fish in the underground lake here.
There's another door, so yeah, I would guess so.
Okay. Looks like a second silo. That's two missiles. You said there were three here?
Yeah, it was a three site. The big one with the water should be somewhere. There's more, yep. So that's it for this wing. I don't see any ups. There's some ventilation. Eventually, all this will be probably flooded. Okay, so we're going to go back down to the main hallway and go check the other wing.
That's the way we came.
So we're going to go down this other side tunnel.
I bet this is the other silo.
Yeah, see, this one still has all the floor that you would have been on. Oh, here's our beam. I guess this is the beam spot.
Yeah, well, it's...
We're scoping it out.
Yeah, I'm not doing that.
You're You're not doing that?
No.
Well, worst case is you're just in like a knee deep of water. I'll let you know once I stand up here. How? If this way is probably the easiest. It's funny that like they removed planking.
Yeah.
Wait,
it doesn't look like there's anything there. There's no floor in that room. So unless you're going to go a long way, I think this is.
So it's another storage tank with a penis. There's something there. It's kind of weird. Just another suspended room and floor. Those might be the big tanks, might be the fueling tanks for the rockets. That side's the best because you got the wall. That once you get around that one pole, you can kind of right there. I want to come back because there's nothing in there.
Yeah, I bet this goes back as far as the other side did.
Well, this is probably the main silo, the one that with the picture. I have decent balance. Just don't stand on the very end and flip up. Stupid. See, you got the wall to hold on. If I didn't have the flashlight in my hand and the camera, that's still video recording, so if I fall in.
So basically, you just cross
that
wall.
Yeah, if you just hold that wall, but you know, I'm holding like.
Just as he's staying right here.
Okay.
So, I think I'm going to stay with him.
Okay. I'll let you know. I bet that's deep water. Oh, here's the beam room. I'm to the room with the beam! Oh, I'm to launcher area number one! So... kind of move the feet. Kind of have a grab rail. It's actually not that bad. Oh my God. This door was huge. Oh yeah, look at the door. Let's get the focus going, guys. Sorry about that. Look at this door. Tunnels and blast lock. Look how fucking thick that was. Wow. Sorry, guys, I have to turn you sideways. Well, I just kind of using, it's not that deep of water, but who knows what's in it, and you know, maybe if you had some high boots, knee-high boots, you could just kind of wade through the stuff. Another blast door. So two blast doors.
Okay, it's dry here.
Oh, made it through. So two blast doors. So you had this one, you have that one. This is definitely the launch area. And then you go down. I'm trying to make it quick just so I can get back because I'm probably out of talking range. It is cold enough down here, I see my breath. But wearing a coat, it feels fine. Oh, wow. All this was suspended floor, but it's funny that this area is not. Squeeze through there. Looks like that way might be flooded. Well, I'll go the unflooded way first. Right? Makes most sense. Okay, coming down. Oh my god, look at this murky pool of water. Some type of springs running on the wall, some type of catwalk. I don't know exactly what type of opening that was. Okay, we'll go back this way. I guess I'll take a look down there. Doesn't look like I'll get far though. It's funny that they took all these supports up. Yeah, I guess if I'm gonna walk. See nothing for a head. Always look down and check for anything that might hit your head, guys. Should really wear a hard hat, actually. If I was gonna do more of this, I'd definitely get a hard hat. Actually, I think I have one somewhere. See, this beam works pretty good. Just kind of move each foot back and forth. Okay, it's still metal. Wow. Looks like that's the end of the pathway, guys. So I can't get in there. As you can see, that's flooded. Although I can see how deep it is. I mean, it slopes down. That's pretty dang deep. And I can't see what's down there. So we're gonna go back. Okay, I can get back on the floor. Okay, now I can go back over that. Squeeze in between there. Oh, that one's slightly. Yeah, so you gotta watch your knees because I just whacked that. Stupid I-beam. Last thing you do is want to hurt yourself real bad down here. It's one way to get this closed down for good. Somebody gets hurt, they'll just bulldoze that entryway shut. There's not really much that would have asbestos. Oh yeah, the ceiling here is wet. That's what's shining. Water drops. A lot of condensation. Moisture in there. I guess I do feel more water. This is blast doors. Just look at that. Look at that. All these years, it still moves. Look, you have ventilation there. I think those could pop shut. Those would pop shut while they're on big steel plates. This was a big door. It's concave, and soon concave would make it stronger. I mean, obviously rusted shut, but there you go. That is awesome. Okay, it's gonna be probably the hard part. So this room, guys, it's not that deep. I was trying to straddle back across. Okay. See how insulated they had that stuff? You know that has asbestos. So don't go kicking it. Which means I'm sure the dirt has some too. I think if I were to do this a bunch, I'd worry more about it, but. Hey guys! Do do do. Okay, go over this. Over that. Over the puddle. Let's go down here real quick. Another room flooded with more support structures. Watch out for stuff like that. Another blast door. So I'm guessing that's another silo. To another blast door. Another. So we did one launcher. This must be number two. It's amazing all this is suspended. These corners for whatever reason. Okay, I'll just jump down. Oh, it turns off. This one actually goes off. Oh man. see, that's stuff you have to watch for. Pulling your other leg up. Nothing on the ceiling. Holy cow. I think it was just another shitter for him.